remember you forever, Eddie. Through the sacrifice you made, we can't believe the price you paid for love.
Hi, I'm Brad Fraser, and this is Spencer Shunk, and you're watching
Old Movies for Young People.
Today, we're talking about, and I'm very excited, Phantom of the Paradise. Now, Phantom of the Paradise is not a movie everybody loves. It bombed on its original release. It got terrible reviews, and in fact, the only place it made money was Winnipeg, Manitoba. For some reason, the movie was more popular there than anywhere else in the world and ran for months and months and is revived regularly. They've done live shows there and they've even had concerts with the original band from Phantom of the Paradise coming to Winnipeg to do it. So Winnipeg has a real Phantom of the Paradise thing going on. I don't know why. It features William Findlay as the Phantom, Winslow, Paul Williams, sadly, as the Faustian character, the Swan, the head of the music industry, and the underrated and far too rarely seen Jessica Harper. The story is a very simple one. She's a singer trying to make it in the world. Winslow is a composer who has a song that Paul Williams wants. Paul Williams captures him, has him horribly mutilated in a record press, so half his face is ruined, and then steals his cantata as a vehicle for Phoenix, played by Jessica Harper.
I don't love this movie. While I think the music is great, I love the sort of macabre aesthetic it has going on and the backup band that keeps reinventing themselves, including dying and coming back to life
exactly.
At one point as the undead. That shit's all great. What it lacks for me is tension, suspense, and a sort of central relationship or even a sort of central character to follow that I can really grab onto.
What choice do you have?
I'll rewrite my cantata, but you best play what I write.
Ink isn't worth anything to me, Winslow. No sign.
The lack of a central character for me is made up for the fact that so many of the ancillary characters, like Beef, he's very gay, but he's also a heavy metal rock star who wears curlers in his hair and has a lisp, but when he gets on stage, he's a muscle guy who does all that loud kind of crazy Megadeth or whatever.
Yeah, no, he's fantastic.
And the actor playing Philbin, who is Swan's henchman.
Right.
I have been in this business a long time. Now, if I don't want to do a show, it's not because I got stage fright. It's because some creature from beyond doesn't want me to do the show. Now, gangway!
Shit, now how did that really happen?
Can't you feel the vibes in your own house? Bad sport. Real bad. I mean, the karma's so thick around here, you need an aqualung to breathe.
The look of the film and the sense of that 70s glitter rock feeling that it has going on really works for me, and for me it's enough to kind of forgive the other stuff that's going on, particularly with the music.
Oh, for me it's not enough to really forgive it, because it feels like a sort of rough assembly of kind of cool little pieces of things, you know, clever ideas that don't really add up to an overall narrative for me, you know what I mean? It doesn't really engage me emotionally.
Right, so I guess we're saying, it sounds like to me, that you might be saying the writing of the script doesn't really work.
In fact,
the script writer, Louisa Rose, is uncredited, and also Brian de Palma wrote a lot of the film as well.
There's Swan on one hand, who's your evil sort of devil kind of character, and then there's Winslow, who becomes quite unsympathetic pretty quick, and then there's Phoenix, who's never really sympathetic.
Well, she is sympathetic until she gets famous. I mean, I think that's
right,
the
maybe
thing.
Maybe we lose it there. Yeah.
And that you brought it up, because the whole point is that Swan wants to make Phoenix a star, so she will love him. Winslow is in love with Phoenix, but she can't see him because he's so ugly, but she loves his music. And what happens is when she finally becomes a star, she dumps Winslow like that and is in bed with Swan in a second. So it kind of takes your sympathy away from our female lead character. The other problem, I think, and I don't disagree with you, I think there is a lack of a central relationship to hang on to in this movie, but there's also nobody who's really fuckable except for Jessica Harper. Like all the men in the, a little bit. You think Jessica Harper is a little bit fuckable?
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh my God, you straight guys are so weird, man. Like, she is totally
Doesn't really do it for me.
In that 70s girl with big black eyebrows and little breasts and long hair, pretty way.
70s girl with the big black eyebrow. I don't know. It's just not a look that appeals to me. But anyway, it doesn't matter.
De Palma is known for sequences, and he's known for set pieces in the middle of films in the same way Hitchcock was and various other people. Often, they're actually Hitchcock's set pieces and not De Palma's. But in this movie, I think it's that final rock concert. Oh, yeah. That you created, getting horny and damn frustrated. You think you must stop and try me up, only you might satisfy me up. Winslow is up in the heavens, he's got a neon lightning bolt sign that he throws into Beef and electrocutes him, and the whole place goes crazy, and Phoenix has to go on to shut them down because there's going to be a riot, and they have the whole crowd at the front of the curtain of the stage, and it opens slowly, and she's standing there alone in a spotlight, and she starts to sing a Paul Williams song. I think it takes horror and 70s pop music and camp and combines them in a really interesting way that at least visually works if it doesn't work entirely in the storytelling and the script.
Yeah, visually I'd say it works. That's the most appealing part of the movie for me. But yeah, it feels like a bit of a hodgepodge.
What do you think? Do you think your generation would get anything from this movie? Or are they too humorless and hung up and tight-assed?
I think besides people who are really into, like really, really into things like the Rocky Horror Picture Show, and even a small percentage of those people, I think this movie would mostly fall flat with people
really?
Of my generation.
Okay.
I could be wrong.
People of his generation, please watch it and leave us some comments and let us know what you think.
And that was Old Movies for Young People.
Or Young Movies for Old People.
Or what are we calling it?
Angry Movies for Happy People.
Sad Movies for Sad, Sad People.
Okay. Thank you. We'll see you next time.
We need a man that is simple perfection. There's nothing that's harder to find. Someone to lead us, protect us and feed us, and help us to make up our minds. We need a man that's sophisticated, quiet and strong and well educated. Where to go? What to do? Cut it.